John Scott's course, the Bonhoeffer text as well as the Schneider course. Isn't that correct? I think you're buying that book. Okay. So I'm not going to go into too much detail about his birth and his background and those sorts of things. You'll read in the text how he came to Christianity. It was a very difficult decision for him to give his life to the Lord, but once he did, as Coach said, he was all in. And that's very much true. So let me just read some selected writings. Some of them are reflections that Bonhoeffer had as well. Oftentimes, what would happen is political prisoners were political because they were religious individuals. If you remember, the whole church in Germany converted to Nazism as a whole. But there was resistance within the church itself for those who didn't follow Nazism, didn't support the Third Reich. And many of those people were arrested. Many of the pastors were arrested. They were incarcerated. Many of them received exactly the same kind of treatment and those sorts of things as others.
Wait, Paul Schneider's the guy who built the zoo, right?
No. That's Carl Koch, the commandant.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Paul Schneider was a political prisoner. He was a pastor. He was a pastor of a church, and he was incarcerated for his beliefs. Yeah, sorry. Carl Koch, that was just something. That was a separate kind of thing. So let that go. And now we're focusing here. So it's on Paul Schneider. But here's some of the things that Schneider. So the story of Pastor Paul Schneider's resistance and his church is an important example of American churches today. One of the things you need to remember is, you know, we've seen Bonhoeffer, his incarceration, not only at Flossenbürg. Here they kept Bonhoeffer for 2 weeks before they transported him to Flossenbürg. And so there is a memorial here as well. We may not get to see that. But many people who stood against Nazism, like I said, were incarcerated and they were punished for their beliefs. Another well-known pastor at the time was Martin Niemoeller. Now, the difference between Martin Niemoeller and Schneider and Bonhoeffer is that Niemoeller actually was a sympathizer of the Third Reich when at the beginning of the war. But he's one of those individuals that he saw that his ethic or the Third Reich's ethic and the worldview didn't match up to biblical Christianity. And so Niemoeller, he was incarcerated in Dachau. So if you go to Dachau, you can see his cell there as well, in the political prisoners' area block as well there. So Martin Niemoeller had a change of faith midway through his incarceration, so much so that he tried as best he could from prison to write letters, to do anything he could to help prisoners politically, anybody to escape, those sorts of things. So that's kind of Niemoeller's story. He didn't die. He was one of the lucky ones who did not die. And after he got out, he became the vice chancellor, vice principal, or vice president, if you will, for the reconciliation movement. And that was an international kind of movement. So he was really an outspoken pastor on behalf of reconciliation and those sorts of things. So that's Niemoeller's story. But Schneider, a few things about him that happened here. Here's some words that Bonhoeffer himself said about Schneider. He said, "This godly Christian man knew no